Hey everybody, thanks so much for joining us today. This is going to be a three-part series where I'll be explaining how to use your iPhone or iPad to capture a 3D model with Matterport. Before we get started, I just wanted to point out that in the description below, we're going to have links to the other two videos in this three-part series, as well as links to additional information in FAQ articles. So here's the list of things that you're going to need to capture a 3D model with your iPhone. First thing is either an iPhone or iPad. If you're using the iPhone, it's going to be the 6S or newer. If you're on the iPad, it can be the Air 2 or newer. But if you're using either an iPhone or iPad with the extra wide-angle lens, which is going to be the iPhone 11 or newer or the new iPad Pro, there is a little bit of a benefit to that, and I'll get to that later. You're also going to need a Matterport account. So if you don't already have one, it's really easy. Just go to buy.matterport.com. It's free. You can sign up with only your name and email address. And lastly, of course, you're going to need the Matterport Capture app. So go to the App Store and search for Matterport. You'll find Matterport Capture. Just download and install that. Once you've got all that, just go ahead and launch the Capture app. At this point, you can sign into your account. You can either do that now or you can do that prior to uploading your model. Either way, before you upload the model, you'll have to sign into your account via the app. Once you're past the sign-in process, the application is going to download Cortex. Now, this is the engine that automatically converts your 2D panoramas captured with your phone into a 3D model. So this is very important. It might take a little bit of time. It totally depends on your internet connection, but it is worth it. And once Cortex is installed, you are ready to go. So at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and hit the plus button in the bottom right corner to create a new model. The address automatically comes up, and I can choose to either edit that address if it's not exactly correct, or I can scroll down and just enter the name of the model that I'd like to have. Hit save, and our model is created, and I'm ready to do my first scan. Before we actually get to capturing the model, which I'll show you in the next video, I just want to point out a couple buttons around the capture button itself. You'll notice just above the capture button is a button that currently says iPhone. And that's because I don't have any other camera connected, so this becomes my default capture device. So if I tap iPhone just above the capture button, you'll notice that appears a small menu that allows me to choose between the iPhone being my capture device or a different camera. The other thing I wanted to bring to your attention is the options button. If I tap that, up comes a small menu. It allows me to choose between 3D scans and 360 capture. There's a lot of information at support.matterport.com that covers the differences between those two, so I won't get into that here. But I just wanted to let you know, if you did need to change to a 360 capture, this is where it would be done. And the other thing, and this is really important, is whether you capture a simple scan or a complete scan. As you can see by these icons, the simple scan is just one ring around, and I'll have a little bit more on the top and bottom that's going to be blurred. But the complete scan completes more of the 360 sphere and allows me to see a lot more in the end. Because I'm capturing three 360 degree rings, it's going to be a little bit more time consuming, but the result will be a little bit more complete as well. In this case, I'm going to keep it on simple. Again, this is because I have the extra wide angle lens in my iPhone 11. So if you do have that, like I said before, it's going to be a little bit of an advantage for this reason. With that in mind, we are ready to scan. So check out video number two, and I'll go ahead and scan this makeshift home office into a 3D model.